Hi guys, and welcome back to another plot review. So we're here again on dakarcraft.nitrous.it. There is a link in the description if you guys want to come on the server and just play and look around and stuff. Anyway, we're actually on one of the C plots. This is actually a plot by Gorilla Plays MC. So yeah, it's pretty awesome actually. So this is a small hideout for pirates. That's what it's been named as. So that's what we're going to be looking at. This small hideout for pirates, which is on a big plot, so it's pretty big. It does remind me a little bit of what's his name's plots, DCK, who then changed his name. I can't remember what he changed his name to, but it's got like inspirationy bits from that, but it's definitely its own plot, if you know what I mean. So underwater, nice little simple details. We've got a nice little boaty thing here, some signs. So there we go, time, day, clear, shade as any. Yep, captain of the pirate ship HMS Stride. Wow. Welcome to the Bay of Sanvara by Gorilla Plays. Enjoy. Find the skeleton heads. I think there are seven, but he has no idea. I actually quite like that. So we've got the wheely thing. This is one of these double wheels. That's actually really clever. I like that. I really like that. That's cool. Huh. There you go. Anyway, I'm just figuring that out. So we've got a kind of boat. I do think the sails are a little bit too flat. They need to just be brought out just a little bit and then tucked in. Either that or if it's going into port, sails would be up. That's my personal thoughts on it straight away. But boatman, kind of. Anyway, so when you actually come in, there isn't really a dock, but I'm guessing they just come in here. They do like the whole Assassin's Creed type of junk. And somehow your boat appears at a dock later on. Your crew just finds the way. Yeah, I'm sure they do. Anyway, we've got all the big fish stuff. Big fish there, small fish. Lots of fish. Some seagulls. It makes perfect sense. So they're cooking up some fish, because that would be their main diet, really. I mean, you've got fish just everywhere. This just feels crazy, though. Like, it feels good. Like, I like the sail type of thing here that looks really natural. Looks really cool. So it looks more like cloth than like solid material, which is really well done with the slab work. We've got all this. We've got some sand just dragged in. Same with this as well. So we've got lots of stuff there. We've got a pirate cave type thing. This has definitely got to be a pirate cave. So there we go. Got that in there, like Smuggler's Cove. But obviously because they're not on a real place, it's different. Pirate King would totally sit here with his treasure map and say, "Arr, I broke my drink. Gar." You know, something like that. Got a little room in here. Look at this. That room. It's filled with stuff. Lots of stuff. I mean, they've got tons of money. God, it's overflowing on this side. And tons of booze as well. They've got lots of everything. There we go. Look at that. They could have done with a couple slabs, maybe just to drop it down. But, yeah. Details, minor details. So there we go. That's the first cave. Okay, so we've got some more seagulls. That one's maybe a little bit low flying. That's what I think anyway. I'd expect them to be up here. And also, this is like, in the next plot, Ghosty has made actually a pretty cool, well done sign thing with the weirdest dude staring that way. Anyway, that's off topic. Anyway, what we've also got here is some sort of whale. So they've cut up a whale and, obviously eating him for some reason. Signed by Luxy. Cool. So Luxy made it well and killed it and had its meat spilling out. But it's still really nice, isn't it? It's really good. And they've got palm tree as well. I think this could have done with using the cobblestone wall just purely because they're so thin, really. There we go. Got that. I'm cutting up the meat. Lots of crows around. It makes perfect sense. And then we've got this, like, walkway going up there. So I'm guessing they just... Oh, yeah. They go across this little thing. I was going to say, I'm guessing how... I don't know how they get there. Okay, that's what we got, as well as jaggedy rocks, some more palm tree type stuff. Well, they've even got a hammock. Oh, awesome. I actually prefer for hammocks, and you guys might agree or disagree. What I find looks really, really good is, obviously, if you go onto this one, you can use the ocean. And if you just use that with the string, just float those two. Then I think that looks a little bit better. But it's still a very interesting idea. That's just my thoughts about it. Should I leave that there? Yeah, that'll confuse somebody in like 10 years' time. It'll be great. there we go. It's got that as well as all these in-cuts. Now, I totally like thought this was going to go into like another cave. It just has that like weird, doesn't it? Do you know what I mean? It's like hidden, but nope, nothing there, but that's fine. Anyway, let's go upstairs. Wow, up these stairs. Okay, that's where they hang people. Found a skull. I definitely found one of them. Let's... Now, this is a town. And I mean, really is a town. Look at it. It's cool. It's very cool. So let's go around here. We've got Kenway's Fresh Fish. He has played Assassin's Creed. Got Gorilla's Girls. I'll have a mess over that way. Okay. They're quite organized pirates, but okay, that's good. Right, let's try and attack this as I do in a logical way. Let's try and attack the town. Do these ones. Do these three here. Something. I don't know. So I don't want to miss. I hate missing stuff. Okay, so there we go. We got this. Lots of fishy stuff. Fishy in there. Over here. Oh, rat. That's a nice touch. Here. Now, this does feel a little bit empty. Something feels empty. Like, this feels really detailed. And then this feels a little bit less. I think it's probably that it just needs, like, something like that. You know, it's like the really, really simple stuff. Or is that just me that it just needs... I don't know. That might just be me. But tell me, guys, anyway, you know, what you think. I want to get into this house anyway. It's got some weird, like, coloured stuff. And I quite like this as well. I like these little side bits. I mean, the house itself looks nuts. I think they're ship-like in form. Like, that one's got a mast sticking out with the flag. This one's got what looks like a sail in it and stuff. That one's got another mast. That's got, like, a top part of a ship or something. So the actual styles are really unique and really crazy. So yeah. Right, so here we go. We've got one big room. That's good. So, simple. Another hammock as well. It's kind of cool. Look at that. I like the roof. I really like the roof. It just seems just really crazy. And you know what I'm like. I like that kind of stuff. Let's go to this house anyway. Quick bunk beds. Cool. A nice little chest of drawers type thing. I like that. Nice little seating areas. This is all fine. I'm good. That's a ton of wine. Jesus Christ, but I like the stand. And upstairs, got like a little balcony area with some storage. Okay, that's fair enough. So that's what we get there. We've obviously got a seating area there. Should we go up this way? It's a weird path. A little bit of grain or something. This goes up to this point. Now, where was that the house we were in? No, it's a different one. Look at that. Another tiny, tiny house. And in here, another tiny, tiny house. I'd really... There's something about the roof that I like. I think it's how he's done the beams. It just makes it look even crazier. Very, like, just slapped together. I actually really like it. It got a hanging tree there as well. With a weird... Oh, it's got a sail in it, sorry. I was thinking that was actually connecting onto something for some reason. Oh, dear. Right, okay. Let's go up to this house here anyway. Go all the way up the path. So this doesn't quite flow so smooth. So I think, yeah, it could do with a little bit more work on the actual paths itself. Because I hate jumping up. So I'm going here. So this is a scroll master of some kind. Bunk bed. Okay, cool. Going here. See, I hardly ever use that as well. I need to start using that. This goes off to somewhere else. I always don't want to go down that way yet. This feels very jungly. It's good. Right, let's get into the rest of it. I think we do the small town bits and we start exploring everywhere else. So we've got Gorilla's Girls. So let's check out this place. Oh yeah, I like this. So that's where you sit down. You got like a... the pimp would be sat there. There you go, look at that. Really nice use of curtains, isn't it? It's cool. And I got another one there. And obviously the girls are into... sort of drugs. I can't get through there. Oh, it's because it's got an invisible piece of glass. That's probably to pull the glass, to pull the curtains, isn't it? Yes, it is. Wow, well done to me. Anyway, it's cool. Got that in there. So yeah, that looks pretty good. It's quite big as well, but it doesn't, like, it looks quite big on the outside, and it's actually is quite big on the inside, but it feels more open. It's quite good. There you go. It's the harbour master. So he could be sat there, couldn't he? Let's go inside. Oh yeah, there we go. That's where exactly where he sits. Harbormaster in there in his little cabin. And yeah, I think it just needs like extra bits of like this or something. It just feels like it's a little bit missing. There we go, got a toilet in there. There we go, cool. And let's go down this way. So it's got quite a good street feel to it. And then back in here, this goes to another house. Okay, cool. Another house, and that has an upstairs. Wait, you hit your head in it, but obviously in real life you'd be able to just duck under it. Ah, Minecraft with your non-duckingness. Yeah, I don't know. Did we go into this one? No, we didn't, did we? That's a new one. Just want to explore all these. Because that goes down that way. We've got another cart thing, cutting some sort of foods. Another hanging tree in case something's really bad. And up here we got a tower. Ooh, oh, I like the angled thing. Now that goes straight up to a big fire thing. So it's like the equivalent of a lighthouse, I guess. Pirate lighthouse. Would they care? They could do, actually, because, you know, they could have friends. Now that, this I don't like at all. No, it needs to have a step up, definitely, with some sort of slabs. 100%. It just... Yeah, definitely needs that. This house we have not been in. I quite like this as well. This one looks a little bit fancier. They've all got like their own like flavour to them. They're all like the same style, but not the same style. I don't know how to explain it. That's got carrots hidden away. Hide the carrots. Okay, that's cool. And then what's over here? Tom's tools and weapons. We've got guns, spears, cave with more stuff. Grass in the cave floor. Not a fan of that. So I don't know what you guys think. Okay, but that's the main bit there. We could go across here and do this little bit. Yeah, let's go across here. So that needs to have some stuff on it. I like this though, the little cart. That's quite good. What have we got in here? This nice little room, isn't it? This seems a bit fancier. I think it's the floor. The floor is very nice mixed in. Hardened clay. And then up here, mud. Mud in the ceiling? Alright. It's actually got mud. Oh yeah, no, it's not mud. No, yeah, it is actually. Yeah, sorry. It's grass. Ha, okay. That's cool. Cool. And then we got a little field here. Simple little field and a windmill as well. Uh-huh. Now, has it the windmill got a mechanism? Thing that I always ask for. And I like the path, and I like how it's on a... I do like how it's been quite brave with the 45, and there we go, it has got a mechanism. I really do like the 45 degree entrances on these. It just makes it a little bit different. It's actually pulled it off very, very well, so well done, Gorilla. Got a big oak tree. It needs a little bit of leaves on the inside, though. It feels a little bit... like, it would just have leaves on the inside. Definitely needs them. Apart from that, the actual tree shape is really good. And I think the outside as well. Yeah, the outside is as well. Just lacking on the inside. It just feels very bare, so it just needs to have joined up bits, definitely. And there goes the scarecrow. It's pretty creepy, actually. But there we go, we've got that. That's another house. No. That's the house we just went in. Okay, let's go around the back. I'm not a fan of this path. I've started to learn not to use this path anymore, this freaking one. Definitely not, but like mixing a little bit of materials. It just seems a bit too samey with the this one, especially when it tiles, like this little blob here, you can see it like tile. So using other textures in does help break it up. What have we got over here? So we've got lots. Oh my god, they got loads. I suppose they got blue wool as well. Is it supposed to be blue wool? I reckon it's not supposed to be. I reckon that's part of the cliff. It's masked it and forgot. The cliffs themselves aren't too bad. Something feels like empty about them. I think what this needs is little bits of the grassy rock, like mixing in down the bottom, as well as a little bit more. So we've got bits of gravel. I don't know, what do you guys think? Because it feels like it just cuts off suddenly. Whereas I think if it had a little bit of the grassy stone, just little bits of it mixed in down the bottom, it would help kind of merge it in. I guess that's what I think. I want to check out these streams anyway, because I've just realized these. Oh yeah, cave. Oh, that was a weird thing. Look at this cave. Oh, I like these. I love it when people do this. A little bit of money. Found another skull. We've only found two. We're doing really badly, guys. We're really doing badly. That goes all the way down here. Now then, streams down. That's interesting. It's definitely interesting. And that then joins into this one. Okay. And we don't want to get too far there. So we've had a look at that section. See, there's more town in there. Let's do that bit in a bit. We'll do this jungly bit, because I actually quite like this, the look of this jungly bit as we walked up. I think the path needs a bit more tweaking to make it smooth, because this you have to jump up. This you have to jump up, which is a bit annoying. But if we go into here, this definitely feels like a jungle. Definitely very cool. I like the vines dropping down as well. And this goes to like a big fire. We've got a tents as well. Cool, and we've got a watchtower as well. Cool, simple watchtower, but very cool. There we go, more tents and stuff. It's cool, like it. And Did we go in this one? Yeah, we did. It's a scroll man. That's not what we're going to call them anyway. And this one also goes up to this, and that is very cool. Oh god, I forgot about that. Yeah, of course he did. Of course Monster added in the rope thing for the jungle. Oh god, I forgot about it. That's cool. There we go, another little tower. And you actually get a pretty good view as well. Wicked. I like it. Okie dokie. Now let's go up here. So there we go. Past Tom's Tools. This path just doesn't feel right though. I don't know what you guys think. It just feels a little bit blocky. Like that trapdoor, don't really care about that. Just move it in and make it a little bit smoother. I think this path does need to be smoother. Like this feels just like bolted on the side. So that it does need a little bit smoothing out on the edges. This goes around to the other town. Okay, well, we don't want to go in that part. We'll go into this part first. Okay, there we go. That goes up to here. Do you like this, though? Where it's all connected in and these weird stands. They look really good with the hoppers. It's just different, isn't it? It's really different. Okay, so this is a big feast that they're having. Big pirate feast. And this is obviously the pirate king. He's got his own big house. There we go. Nice seaty areas. Cool. And, oh, no, this is a tavern. Okay, I was wrong. Orchard Ale. Captain Jack Rum. What's that? Flat Tire Lager? Low Tide. What? I'm just still like, Flat Tire Lager? Why would you call it? The tires didn't exist back in these days. They sailing ships. God damn it. Anyway, this is very nice. Look, that's got to be like a... Oh, it's a piano. Oh, my God. Sorry, it just took a little while because I was like, checkers? And then as soon as I stood back, I saw the piano. Actually, a very nice little piano, actually. Very simple. Cool. I like it, though. There you go. It's very cool. Is there an upstairs with this as well? Or... Nope. Doesn't need one. That's fine. And what have we got around it? Here we got bits of detail and stuff. Yeah, there's always bits of detail. So that means we can go to section number 2, which is over here. Sorry, section number 2, though, is it? No. Weird yellow house. This is very crazy. I like the craziness of it all. Oh, there we go. There's a little house in there. Okay, so that's one. When you go up, you get another house. Okay. Well, not really a house. This is like a little kitchen area. It's really weird and separate, isn't it? Up here, we get another house here. Okay. But how do we get up to this bit? That's what I want to know. There's a door there. That's really weird. Unless it's like a... I'm guessing he's made one building and then put lots of little houses in it. Now that, again, I think this tree needs stuff in it. Tree needs stuff. Just like connecting it across, 100%. But the candles are interesting. Those are really interesting, actually. So what do they use this tree for? That is different. How do you even get there? Ah, there's a little path there. Right, okay, there we go. I'm an idiot. But I like the trees around it. Like skulls and stuff. Okay, so the dead are there. Okay. I've already been over there. So there we go. That's what we've got there. Let's wander around. We've got Chris's carpets. Again, this definitely needs a path going up, as well as Mark's maps. Yep. And that doesn't go around anywhere. Okay, so we've got those two. Like a couple more shops. So how do you get up into this top bit? Did I miss a section? Unless it's around here. Is there any bit that you can get into the top bit? Unless you can't get into this top bit, but it just looks like you can. What have I missed? What did I miss? Or can you not get in there? Oh, you can. I'm an idiot. I knew it. No, I found it. I found the secret. It's not really a secret. Anyway, that's pretty much it, guys. I think there's still bits that can be improved, mainly with the paths and things. Could just be mixed in a little bit better, I think, and less of the 3:1. I've stopped using it completely now because it's good, but it can tile too much. I think you can rely on it a little bit too much. But there you go, guys. That is like a small pirate hideout by Gorilla Plays MC. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. Obviously, if you guys want to come and have a look at it yourselves, feel free to do so. The IP is dakercraft.nitrous.it. You guys can come and build. You guys can just chill out for a bit. You can have a look around and get some inspiration, get some ideas going. And of course, you guys can also put up a video for... Well, a video? You guys can also put up a plot for review. Anyway, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed the video. If you have, come on, like, subscribe. I'll see you on the next one.